tell with that one.
Dude, I don't know what's going on. Does this thing look fucking janky from behind? It feels like if it had two springs and one was stiffer than the other.
Check it.
When I'm flying, when I try to go fast, it feels like it just gets... When it's tracking, it feels like it wants to just flick me off. Like it gets...
All right. Come back here for me. You all right? I can breathe. I can freaking breathe. Oops. What the hell is it doing? It's inside, ain't it? Yeah. Your mouth breather. You gotta breathe out your nose, man.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, I guess the story's on there now. Really, can you pop that up? Just a little bit. You can get it over there. That's why I'm always, don't you notice I'm always reaching up to them going like this? Yeah. And then whenever we slow down for a minute, dude, I flick it up and I ride to my face to show you.
What is it you're pushing to crack this fucking thing open?
Right here.
Oh, so it just pushes up.
You can let a little air in that. Let me finish it.
Mine's new and tight enough like yours should be that it should stay even just a cunt hair open. Yeah, and then mine, now that I got it just where I want it for the most part or know where it's at, it don't bother me now. And I face it too cold, but it's a fine line.
See, he's got vent. Look in the vent.
Once you've got it changed,
okay, yeah, here's your vent. Okay,
every time we stop.
I got my vents all wide open, I believe.
Every time we stop, this is what it does.
Well, that's not, like I said, that's why I use the standard. Because every time I stop, I fog too. So with it here, the only thing I have to worry about is my glasses.
Yeah.
Because with it here,
this guy needs to learn how to breathe through his nose anyway.
Well, he's a little old to learn how to do stuff like that.
I see.
So how's the sled?
It's good.
You ride all right?
Yeah.
You're not fighting or nothing?
Yeah, no, it's good.
Got plenty of power?
Yes.
Okay.
I don't think this is working.
You don't think the handballs are working?
I don't know. This one is. You see it. Yeah. Perfectly down.
Huh.
I flipped it up on that now that we stopped.
Well, you know. Maybe a wire broke or something.
Yeah, I do.
Because they're the same, you know.
Yeah.
I'll look at it when I get home.
Yeah, I'm just saying, if you maybe figure this thing working out.
And then when you get rolling, you just
pop it down.
Right.
I just ain't bored thinking enough to know what the hell it's supposed to do, you know?
And the problem is, because I think we're probably only going to go to Ross Common, because I can't accurately navigate. I told him, I actually built us like a route on a computer and then downloaded it to my phone. But when I was downloading my phone, the fucking thing did an update over the internet and it deleted all the settings I put in it, including my Mac. So I have Macs, I have GPS, we're not lost.
We've
been here before because this is like the main highway.
Einstein, but I mean, you take me somewhere.
I know F-Com right there.
Yeah, this is.
I know F-Com or F-Com or whatever the hell it says.
I don't know. That's what we used to say.
Yeah,
we're
going to go up here.
I remember being here before.
We're going to go up here and hang a left, and that'll take us to last home. A couple miles up here, that's all. I don't think you guys have been north yet. We came. This is the St. Helen Bend.
That's how we went last time. Does that too.
It's actually the trail.
It probably is.
No, you're right.
One day I kept telling him there's something wrong with the front end on that other one.
The trailers
were freaking so hard packed that the freaking runners would get in them, and that's what
I'm saying. Here's how you can tell.
I'm having a hard time getting
the fresh snow,
right,
and it stopped feeling.
Stopped doing
it. Your tracks, here's the problem with snowmobiles. They're almost all exactly the same width.
Well, yeah.
So you're going down the trail, your tracks.
I feel like
I follow yours a lot because they're the deeper, fresher looking ones behind me most of the time. Maybe they're not because yours, now that I'm seeing yours up close, they don't seem to look quite the same. But I don't know. Either way, I swear they're like this much bigger than mine or something. Because it's like it always is super weird.
I'm just getting my soda to take a shot.
Yeah, I don't know what the.
And it feels like, and I gotta imagine the guy who had it was probably weighed more than me. And it...
Actually, dude, you kind of want it as soft as you can without it bottoming out too hard.
I don't know what it is.
We'll look at it when we get back.
It just feels different this time than it did before when I rode.
Well, the trails are totally smoother, but the problem with smooth trails that are packed down, you're those ruts that are in the trail, you're gonna grab the ruts a little bit more. There's two things you can do with that. You can speed up and you can slow down.
Between the two of this one and the other one, the other thing I noticed this does, I call it what I think, what I feel it does. The toy water. Unfortunately. Does it do that to you? And the reason I'm saying that is because I can almost guarantee you why I think it's doing that, is because the freaking track's different. You know what I'm saying? It's like having a freaking this brand new pretty track, isn't it? The great big song, this, and I ain't used to
it. Okay. I haven't adjusted it since
you've been riding. No, that's not the thing. I feel it doing this.
The track
will
sort of wobble a little bit more on the
left. Right. And it's almost the difference between having, if you have older tires on your car, it puts the tires on the left. It's like that one better sticky truck that I had at one point in time. It always felt like a road to the street. You know what I'm saying? And then I went and spent a whole lot of money on brand new, nice tires. It's like, damn, this can be so fucking satellite. No, you know. So
I felt this the other day, but I've never felt it before. The only problem was you were driving on the road that was there.
Right, so you can't tell. That's why I told Kyle about that freaking the other one. I'm thinking the freaking thing won't turn and something's messed up on the truck. So I stopped and I'm looking inside and I'm like, well, I see a stick or nothing. Because I thought it was.
This is how they are.
And then he took us through the woods and did the same thing. He's like, it was running fine when you were on that loose snow, but as soon as you got into them fucking tracks, they were closed. He didn't want to turn.
Plus, there was only one set of tracks through, like, you know how deep it is in the deepest part of your yard? It's like having one set of tracks that got frozen. Are you trying to turn in them?
It just rustled.
It just wasn't going, man. It's like, okay, yeah, I thought something was wrong. You know?
There's ways to get rid of that. My sled has them. Set to start on a carbide.
Really?
Yeah. It's got two sides that side by side.
Well, if you're thinking wide frequency, then you know what's going on. But for me, it rolling 50 meters or whatever, we never rolled that much over there. What we had is always beat up the knees anyway.
Well, here's one of the deals. Like I said, you can speed up a little bit.
Yeah.
Because if you speed up, then what happens is the front of the plug gets rolling, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Guess what?
Okay,
you're not doing the track as well. You're not fucking tracking so deep in the other guy's track.
Right.
So if you kind of, speed up and work around the trail, then you can find it. Because as long as I can see, I'll use the whole trail.
That's what I'm trying to find
a good smooth section.
And I know we're going into a freaking curb or something. I'm staying tight on the
You
got to
get right over. But if I can see, I'll use the middle of the trail. Yeah. I'll use all of them if I can see just to make a good smooth ride.
Yeah.
But does it hit bumps better?
Yeah.
I mean, it's got all brand new shocks and stuff.
It rides good.
We'll tighten up the track. When the track's brand new in the first year, it's going to stretch quite a bit.
Oh, yeah. Like anything else.
Right. And then after a while, it's going to slow down and not stretch enough. But for that one, there's never really been adjusting. It's just going to slow down
for that.
But it might be wiggling around a little bit.
Getting warm up right here.
Yeah, my chain's better than shit with no balaclava. Other than that, I'm fine.
Well, I got, yeah, I mean, that's the only spot that even gets, it's not cold where I can't take it, but that's the only spot I'm going to get.
Yeah, and this one is with that thing or whatever, but this blue one, I think, is too much. The old man was talking about talking old man. I don't know why I'm old man. That's great. Right there. Right there. The older fella that you were talking to. He's got one of those freaking things, but it looked like he was a little, it wasn't like that. It was heavy.
The balaclava? Oh, yeah, no, you can give him the rest of it. The one I wear normally is insulated.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's insulated, and it has a... Yeah, it's insulated, and it has a plastic cover over there. I'll show you.
Yeah, so these are freaking serious for wearing. When it wasn't so freaking cold,
and I'm sure this would be the same freaking thing. See, that's why I pulled this down, because he's there. I always had trouble breathing since he was out. If I breathe out of my freaking mouth, and then I have to breathe into your mouth.
If you don't have glasses, you're going to need a diver, and your palms will go away. You don't need to wear glasses. You'll never see another phone like that. You got glasses to meet them. It's only half the problem.
I'm good with that as well.
Okay, try not to, when you pull this down, try to leave this where I got it, because that's about as low as
you can see it. Because
the next level up might be... You got more warmth on your face than I do, so you might be able to...
I tried riding the phone beam with it up, and it was like, being like, feel like sitting...
I breathe in real nice and deep every time, and then when I blow out, it's real slow off my nose for most part. But once I got it cracked just right and just rolling consistently, the air just tunes out for me. So you see, I picked with it, but I've already been drinking with it a lot to get comfortable. You gotta get used to doing it with your gloves if you want to dump it here or there. And
so, the other night, I sent you that crack that I like that Jim Wells character. Kyle said you want to freaking...
I didn't know what the hell you were talking about.
Kyle's thinking, saying, so he mentioned something to me. I just happened to be freaking watching this guy. Because Kyle told me about him before, you know, and I'm like, so I started watching him here and there. But he's always killing stuff or hunting with a blowgun or a freaking bow or a recurve bow or something.
Spears,
climbs up
the
trees
and
jump kills
with nothing.
Kills critters with spears, right? But I see him shooting his freaking coyote with a freaking recurve bow. He shot that one right in the freaking head, didn't kill him, just pissed him off and he ran away, you know?
They got pretty hard heads, yeah.
That dude's pretty cool to watch, dude. He gets tuned up by stuff sometimes, because he'll go different places. I think he's from Michigan, and he started doing all this stuff here, but now he's kind of, I think he'll go to Africa and stab boars and stuff, but, yeah, he don't do nothing the easy way, dude. You know, like, literally, ground blind, and the bear comes out, and he's like, nah, and throws it at me. He's like, what do I do?
You gotta freaking run. Yeah, he did that the other night. That freaking bear, that freaking bolt, that bitch is gonna kick his ass.
Linda called me a book. That's why I woke up this morning. She said the fucking coyote was running around the yard this morning at 8 in the morning.
So you're actually seeing it. It ain't the freaking neighbors.
She said, this one wasn't limping, and he was fucking dead.
Hey, once they get so bad, so many.
I'm going to have to hunt them. I can't know. Two guys probably in there.
Okay, so you get the freaking alpha male or whatever, because usually they're bigger and more aggressive, and they're not. A lot of times they don't have a fear of freaking people because they're used to people, you know?
I've only seen them walking around during the day once, and that was Thanksgiving a year ago.
Yeah, see,
now
the little, I seen some of them little calls, and you put them like 30 yards out. So if you was sitting in your freaking barn, in your garage, and you know, you set it out somewhere underneath the tree. Some of them got little freaking things on them that look like actual movement of freaking hand, a little fur or something. But I got one that's just a mouse call. Me and Kyle were trying it, but, you know, but the thing is that if you know they're there, From what I've read, the guy said most of them will tell you if they're freaking there, and they can, and if they know if you're downwind of them, they'll know you're there. A lot of times they'll see you before you see them. But his thing was within 15 freaking to 30 minutes, they're gonna come out. You know what I'm saying? Because they have this inborn freaking thing. Yeah, they have this inborn freaking thing about freaking dying animals, you know what I'm saying? That screaming, or howling, you know?
It's an easy meal.
Yeah. All right, so.